attack the issue and not the person, unless the person becomes the issue. All right, and my name is TJ, and I'm your facilitator for the journey today. But before we get started, right off the bat, please do me a favor.
Acknowledge me.
Acknowledge the real Bravado Network. Acknowledge the chat. Acknowledge those who just came from Take Heed to the Message. Acknowledge those who support Almanize. We got to get her channel going, guys. We got to get her monetized. She's just under 300 subscribers. We're going to make a push to get her to her 1,000 subs. So if you have not gone over to Almanize76, please go over there and subscribe to the sister's channel. Watch a video, make a few comments, do some likes. I believe she has a premiere coming out. I don't know if it's tonight or tomorrow. But go over there and check out the sister. Check out Take Heed to the Message. I just dropped the link. So I know those of you don't really know what I'm going to be getting into totally today, but Black Man Unfiltered, I see your brother, wipe the cheeseburger kernels from your beard. Come on up, brother, have a conversation with me, because we're going to be talking about something that we really don't talk a lot about, and we're going to be talking about friends. Right, we're going to be talking about friends today, boy, and we're going to be talking about specifically, what the purpose of friends are and what they mean to us in our life. And one of the things that, we're really going to get into a little bit about, can men and women actually be friends? Now, the only people that I've ever heard that has come up and actually continuously talk about this subject is women. Men don't talk about the subject of men. Can men and women be friends? Because we already know the answer to that. So, but we're going to be talking about friends today. And let me tell you something. Hold on. I got some, over the course of my life, of course, it's a rare thing if you hit 40 and you're still friends with one or two people from your childhood. And I have from my childhood, there's only one person that is left in my life, one guy friend that is actually left in my life from childhood. But friendship is something totally different than the way women think about friendship. But we're going to get into that. But before we get moving on the subject, hold on a second. I gotta do something real quick.
Money making is my thing, cause I'm trying to be rich, trying to put away meals.
Here comes the money.
Here we go.
Shout out to Almanize with the $5 super chat. Hey King, welcome back. I ain't going nowhere. Welcome back. I ain't going nowhere. I wasn't in captivity. I wasn't in jail. I wasn't released from prison. Can't wait to hear what you have to say. Let's have the conversation. Absolutely. And then she's running it back again with another $2. Thank you for the $2. And we always got to acknowledge those $2.
These last $2.
Yeah, we got to acknowledge those. Thanks for the endorsement. No, we all need to help, because we got to build a community over here. But so we're going to be talking about, we're going to spend some time today really, really diving into the thing, this concept of friendship.
How many of us have them friends? Ones we can depend on.
But first.
Let me talk to you.
Let me talk to you for a second. Before we get over and talk about friends, I want to talk a little bit about, did I just say friends?
Friends. How many of us have them? Friends.
Yeah. before we get over talking about friends, let's talk a little bit about up front. Let's talk about this. I did not realize until relatively recent that there's another sub war going on between with black folk besides the relationship war. There's also, I'm thinking that there's a generational war that's going on with black men, with older experienced black men, younger black men. So I think there's a little bit of a war going on because I know a lot of us are familiar with the Willie Lynch letter. And regardless if you believe it's a real thing or not a real thing about the Willie Lynch letter, but one of the things that points out in the Willie Lynch letter, as it's describing how to break a slave, one of the things that the Willie Lynch letter is talking about is pitting the old man versus the young man. And it goes into great detail about why that's important to pit the old man versus the young man. But the whole concept of the Willie Lynch letter is to keep blacks separate, divided, and distracted. Because if you can keep them separate, divided, and distracted, you can subjugate them. And then if you do that enough over the course of generations, they will start to subjugate themselves, and you don't have to put any influence in them because their teaching will become a self-fulfilling prophecy. So I'm not going to get into a real philosophical debate over this right now, but I really want to take a look at, I've become very friendly with the YouTube channel, This Might Be Risky. They were having a conversation, and the conversation went left between what they perceived to be the younger man and the older man. And I had been seeing this a lot, and this conversation is starting to come out a little bit more around black men about the fact that the black men are actually blaming each other for the failures of the community. They're blaming them across generations. Now, I'm a firm believer in accountability, and there are things across generations that were done that has hurt us, that has helped us get to the point that where we are now. I tend to look at these things as a historical teaching lessons, but that's not how I think the majority of black men are viewing this. I didn't realize that we might be the generations, like the Zennials, Millennials, Generation X, and the baby boomers, that we all might be at war with each other. And I really have not really paid that much attention. So we're going to take a look at this clip, and we're going to get into it. And I know some of the fellas get pissed at me when I start pointing out the things that we should not be doing and the things that we should not be saying and the behaviors that we are exhibiting out there. I know a lot of fellas think that I'm jumping off code or off message or something like that. I am not, because I'm all about holding accountability and for us being responsible for the things that are our responsibility. So let's get into this real quick, and we're going to talk about it. This is why I dropped the link, and I'll do it again because I'm being serious, for someone to come up, because we need to have the conversation. This is not just a conversation about the guys. It'd be nice to get a lady's perspective on some of this too. And we got to talk about this right here before we get to the conversation about, about friends.
Ones we can depend on. Friends. How many of us have them?
So we gotta do that. So without any more delay, let's get to the
Hey, Mandrell, were you able to talk to UT? Did y'all come to common ground?
No, I just hope he got he understood the point I was trying to make. It wasn't a shot at him necessarily, but it's just this generation. Y'all tend to take shit way too personally.
No.
You know what I'm saying? It's just
that was smoke, bro. Yeah, that was smoke.
So the light-skinned guy, the high yellow brother with the red thing on his hat in the lower corner, just talked to the fella in the top on the second fella with the do-rag on. He basically just told him, hey, man, we can't tell y'all nothing because your generation is so damn sensitive. So this is the first shots fired in this conversation.
Even if it's smoke, you don't take it personally.
Nah, but you was like Uncle Jeff's wingman though when they was having a smoke. So you trying to
hold on. Okay, you sorry.
Two days in a row.
Hold on. How old are you? He knows.
I'm 32.
That's why you take.
I didn't take it personal. I watched the podcast, and it seemed like you came out of left field. I'm just addressing it.
I got a question for the.
So, before Angry Man gets to his question, a lot happened in those first few seconds of the exchange. I'm going to go back. I'm going to replay it. A lot has happened in those first few seconds of that exchange, okay? And I'm going to talk about this. And a lot of you probably missed it. So I'm going to point it out to you. Okay, here we go again.
Hey, Mandrell, were you able to talk to UT? Did y'all come to common ground?
No, I just hope he understood the point I was trying to make. It wasn't a shot at him necessarily, but it's just this generation. Y'all tend to take shit way too personally.
No.
You know what I'm saying? It's just
they
that was smoke, bro. Yeah, that was smoke.
Even if it's smoke, you don't take it personally.
Nah, but you was like Uncle Jeff's wingman though when they was having a smoke. So you trying to
hold on, okay, you sorry.
Two days in a row.
Hold on, how old are you? He knows.
I'm 32.
Okay, a couple things right now that a lot of guys give women a lot of bullshit and crap about is the fact that we get pissed off for. The fact that we talk about that women always want to talk over us. We can't have a conversation. In the first 10 or 15 seconds of this clip, all of these guys are doing nothing but talking over each other. And you can't understand it. You can't. It's nothing but noise. But I'm going to try to break it down for you a little bit. So one of them asked one of the guys on the panel, how old are you? And the guy says, I'm 32. I don't know where this went wrong in our culture, but we are so fucked up that we call a 32-year-old a kid or young. And we have a habit of calling people that are old fuckers. When you're 30 years old, you're not a young person no more. I don't care what your mind tells you. I don't care what society, what black culture tells you. I don't care what your mammy tell you. If you are 30 years old, you are not some young motherfucker no more. You are a full-grown man. You are a full-grown woman. If you are a female and you are 30, you are a fucking middle-aged woman. From a biological standpoint, from a reproductive standpoint, you are a fucking middle-aged woman. But in our culture, we have developed this mindset that no one is allowed to grow up and no one is allowed to be an adult until they're 60. We talk to each other and we sit up here and we call full-grown old ass adults, kids. They're not kids. A 30-year-old, a 32-year-old, a 28-year-old, a 25-year-old is not a damn kid. That is a full grown adult. We have in the black culture, we have this idea that we are to remain a child until we're damn near 60 years old. And then we sit around at 45 and 50 years old trying to figure out why we ain't where we need to be when we've been sitting around being called a kid. I'm 46 years old. There are people in my family who call me a damn kid. And I'm a 46, I'm an old ass dude. And I'm being called a kid. We got 20 mid-20-year-old people being called a kid. If a 30-year-old or 32-year-old is a kid, then how do we get people like Medgar Evers, Martin Luther King, Marcus Garvey, Nat Turner, hell, Jesse Jackson, Barack Obama, at 20, in their mid-20s into their 30s, these men had families, had children, had careers, were leading movements. And in the case of Barack Obama, we're not talking about politics. We're just using him for because we all know who he is. He was leading a country. But we call somebody a kid or young that's in that generation, that's of those ages. It's like we have been conditioned to continually be in a constant state of arrested development. Everybody watching live right now or on the replay, if you are Black, you got about 10, you can probably name 5 to 10 men in your family in their 30s living in their mother's fucking basement. Living in their mother's basement on their auntie's couch, living with their sister, couch, and everybody keeps saying, oh, he got time, because he young. Shout out to my homeboy, Kofa. Go ahead and unmute for me, Kofa.
What's going on, bro? Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Yeah, man. Peace. What's going on, y'all? What's going on to the chat? Peace, everybody.
I'm up here fired up, brother.
I see. You started out early, man. You
we ain't even got to the friendship stuff yet. I'm just, and I'm only, what, 10 seconds into a clip? Into the first clip we're going to talk about.
You already on your rant, man.
Man. These people. Let me tell you something. What really made me start to address this issue or deal with it a little bit is, especially this age thing that we got going on, is because where was I at? Oh, I was listening to This Might Be Risky podcast, and they had this example of this guy who was a supervisor at a job, and he was talking to a lady on the job that was asked her some questions, some personal questions, and she was like 24, 25. So the ladies on that panel was calling this 40-year-old man, asking this 25-year-old woman a creeper, and they kept calling the girl a little girl. They kept calling this 24, 25 woman a little girl. That's not a fucking little girl. That's a grown-ass goddamn woman. And it's not a creeper thing. Look, Kofa, prior to modern times, believe it or not, a 25-year-old woman, it was not uncommon for her husband to be 38 or 40 years old.
Not at all. I talk about it all the time on my channel, bro. My parents been married 43 years. My parents are 12 years apart. My mother got married when she was 21, 22, had me at 23, 24. So my pops was already in his mid-30s. It wasn't uncommon before. It wasn't nothing wrong with it.
No,
but a lot of people look at it from a standpoint of that sugar daddy age. Like that's like our childish mentality in our community, I believe you were speaking to, is he's only good for one thing, and that's, you know, provision or whatnot, which is his job. But it's not even in the context of marriage or in the context of the family. It's just about pay my bills for this one individual woman. So she's still being taken care of like a little girl. And now you got women in their 30s, 40s, 50s, even still think they 22.
Yeah.
And the same thing with men. It's a lot of men, like you said. But I think the question is pertinent because I started noticing that too, just looking around this YouTube space. A lot of the cats that are in their early 30s, I say it all the time, they're not going to hold a lot of these women accountable. They're always going to put it back on the men because they're still in their little boy phase. They're still looking at the world through their mother's eyes. They're not going to hold the women accountable because to hold the women accountable, they'll have to hold their mother accountable for the same type of behavior. So they're still moving like mama's boys, like son husbands.
And Kofa, everybody's doing it. This is not a black man doing this to these cats. This is not a black woman doing it. We are all looking at somebody that's between the ages of 25, let's say 25 and 35, and we're calling them motherfuckers kids.
Kids.
They're not kids. I just said, everybody watching and listening right now, every black person watching and listening right now know at least 5 to 10 family members who are in that age bracket who still living in their mama's house, auntie house, or sister house on the couch.
And don't think nothing wrong with it.
And don't think, and calling them kids.
And see, the issue what I have, where I go with the angles that I go at on my channel is, it's so many women that'll talk cash shit to dudes in their 40s, the me's and the you's, that actually have means, but because we see things as they are, and then when we speak on it, we're the little boys, we need to get out our feelings, but they sleeping with dudes that actually still live with their mama. And then they'll turn around every time we hear these women speak is, oh, y'all niggas do this, 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 this. But those are the guys y'all are sleeping with. Those are the guys y'all are procreating with. So it creates a narrative that nothing's wrong with it. So nothing's wrong with you being in your mama's house as a grown ass man. Nothing's wrong with you being underdeveloped, arrested, all that stuff. We have normalized it. And a lot of people are still holding on to, I guess, this woke hope. I've kind of let go of that, bro. This is where we are. I don't know how to get out of this hole from my perspective. I don't know how to get out of this hole because it's so normalized that people, like you said, in that age range are still viewed as kids or they're doing childish things and it's acceptable.
Let me sidetrack real quick to one of your points. I do not tolerate when I got a woman around me or talking to me, or I'm involved with a woman with me, and I know that in her history, she's never dealt with, I call it a 10 toes down guy. She's never dealt with a 10 toes down guy, and she got one or two kids by one or two guys, and those guys are a bunch of fucking bums, or they're children still, you know, at least developmentally. I don't let that woman tell me shit. You can't impose a standard on me when your fucking 8-year-old kid's father is living in his mama's basement and he still got to take the goddamn city bus to the goddamn job and he 40 years old. Fuck you. Fuck him. You don't get to tell me nothing. You ain't got...